Well, when I was growing up, which is a long time ago, we didn't really have a cuisine. We didn't really have food. I remember going to California for the first time in the late 60s and being astonished by what was available in the supermarkets. I'd never seen an avocado pear. I didn't know what it was. But the color and the variety was just, I felt that I was hallucinating. And it was delightful. It was delightful to discover food. My wife is American. She taught me how to cook. I remember saying to her, she was cooking a steak, and I said, "Is that garlic?" And she said, "Yes." And I said, "You can't put garlic on a steak." And she said, "No, no, no, I wouldn't think of it." And then I ate the steak, and I said, "This is a wonderful steak. What is it?" She said, "It's garlic." So I had to be taught how to eat. And it's one of the great civilizing things that's happened in Ireland. I mean, we only started to get good restaurants here in the late 1980s. Before that, it was either, there was one wonderful restaurant, a French restaurant, Patrick Guilbault, which was here for about 30, 40 years, but it was so expensive that we couldn't afford to go in those days. But when the new good restaurants started up, it was a civilizing influence. Well, I certainly, as a writer, it's writing about food and eating is as difficult as writing about sex, because you can't communicate the pleasure. The pleasure is purely personal. But yes, I think that a good meal is an erotic experience in the widest sense of the word. A good glass of wine, a good piece of bread. You know, I mean, good bread is. I had a meal in a very famous restaurant in Girona yesterday, and I had 18 courses. The thing that I will remember is the bread, which was superb. So I like simple food, and I like small restaurants, which are noisy, and I can hear women laughing, and I can hear people having a good time. The trouble about the very greatest restaurants in the world is that people don't actually have a good time. They just want to be seen there, they want to be able to say that they were there. But there's nothing like going into a tiny restaurant on a foggy night in November, and the patron says, "Oh, Mr. Banville, welcome back. Sit down, have a glass." You have a glass and you have some food. What could be more delightful than that, apart from going to bed with somebody that you love? Well, look, in a time of growing nationalism in Europe, which is going to be disastrous for us, you know, I don't envy you, people of your age, the Europe you're going to have to live through. In a time of growing nationalism, it's very important to have international festivals. And governments and organizations like the Alliance Française should keep financing them, because it is important to get people to meet each other and to realize that, you know, because somebody's German or French or Japanese or Korean, you know, that they're not wicked, they're just people like us. That's the great value of festivals.